Hi, this is Iyas Lawrence. Saya adalah seorang podcast host dan juga penyiar radio. Hari ini, I'm going to talk about the shift of digital demands dan juga the growth of content creators. Hanya di Plaza Indonesia Masterclass. Hai, mungkin heran melihat saya dan bertanya saya siapa. But, you know, that's okay, because I really want people to not know who I am, but know what I do instead, which is Makna Talks. Makna Talks is a small media company. That's what I, at least, like, that's what I like to think. Cuman, it started off as a podcast. Sebuah podcast di mana berbicara dengan individu lainnya setiap minggu. So every Friday I talk with different individuals. I ask questions that are probably that sometimes they say, how do you know that? You know, because I'm based off research. I spent a few years working as a journalist, traveling here and there. And I guess that was a piece of me that, you know, was brave enough to finally make Makna Talks. I think in the late 90s when the dot-com boom era happened, people didn't trust it. People don't know what triple W was. People didn't really care about, you know, how it's gonna affect the people's life. Not until I think even the late 2000. I think even in the late 2000, technology wasn't the main purpose, or it wasn't in the front, you know, helping people out. It was a tool. It wasn't the center or the reason why people was working. You know, technology helped people. Technology helped bankers, for example. Technology helped malls, but it wasn't the reason why people, you know, had the internet, or I guess why people were shifting demands. Tapi today, I think it was a wake-up call in 2019. When the pandemic happened, or even in 2020, that we realized that it was a solution. Technology wasn't only a tool, but it was also the center, and it was up and forward. Dan disitulah menyadari bahwa dengan adanya teknologi, there was a demand. There was a shift in digital demand. Just like we talked about the radio. People are still listening to the radio today, when they commute, when they travel. But the shift of digital demands towards, let's say, Spotify or other streaming platforms, they rose and rose and rose, only because not only because people were actually, you know, interested in, let's say, Spotify or Apple Music, but also they realized that it was easier for them. And that's, I guess, that woke people up. That woke, I guess, entrepreneurs, businesses. That woke up, I don't know, even individuals that are actually struggling. Karena ketika demand di digital, you know, when it rose that high all of a sudden, people started to realize that I can not only use technology as a tool, but also as a proper use of, I guess, making money. For example, if you see the bank today, you used to go to the teller, say, hey, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. Tapi now, it's all digital, a tap from your phone. And that is the shift of digital demands. Very similar to the retail apocalypse, if you know about that. Ketika, you know, big brand coffee shops are not as famous or not as, you know, not as high in demand as, let's say, cooler or smaller coffee shops. That's, I guess, what's happening in this digital era. Dan salah satu penggunaan atau efek dari digital era ini, di mana brand shift membuat sebuah, I guess, perubahan, begitu pula cara mereka menjualnya, marketingnya, strateginya. That is the rise of creators, or digital creators, yang dibagi dari beberapa nama, including buzzers, influencers, content creators. Now, easily, let's divide them. Buzzers, I think it was just a term used earlier in the day because people don't know what to call them. It's just a way to buzz up their business. Then we have influencers, where I think is different to content creators. The amount of influencers you decide to influence somebody by being paid, by using something, that's an influencer. Whereas a content creator is you create something. You're known as a creator. Let's say photographers are content creators because they create content of their photography work. Painters are also content creators. They paint to create content out of their painting using brands as well. Tapi pertanyaannya adalah, ketika semua memiliki panggung, siapa yang akan menonton? It's not about the bigger the stage or how fancy your stage is. It's the quality of your stage. Beda platform atau beda source seperti YouTube atau mungkin bedanya social media memiliki beda individu lainnya, individu gitu. But for what I know, if we talk about Instagram, if we talk about this, I guess, app where you see people instead of you hear them and, or watch them, diawali dengan siapa yang memiliki panggung lebih besar. You know, who has more followers, who has, a bigger reach. But now, I don't think that matters a lot. Because, you know, with this demand or the shift of digital era, it's no longer about, as I said, the bigger the stage. But it's about seberapa jujur panggung kalian. Dan juga seberapa intimate panggung kalian. As I'm saying, if you're wearing black all day, if you're wearing, you know, if you're such a coffee person, and somebody comes up and say, hey, you know, I wanna endorse you with something that's not you, you know, you're already faking it. And I think that's, you're only taking it because, you know, you want the bigger stage. You want what other people are having. But in fact, that's not it. It's about intimacy. It's about, hey, I use it every day. I really like it. And that's the reason why, I guess, people should understand. It's to understand the fact that, am I a user? Do I love the product? Will I share it to my friends? Or are you doing it for the money? Because doing it for the money, you know, you do it once, then you do it again, then you do it again. At the end of the day, there's a bigger chance that you're gonna be fake, you know? And that's the worst thing an influencer can be, or a content creator. But that's on the Instagram. Now, it's much more concerning if you go to YouTube, because you're talking to a bigger crowd, you know? You don't have to subscribe to see you on that page and to be able for you to say, hey, check out what I have, you know? Hey, I've been using this every day, but you're not. That's even a worst case scenario because you are the reason why people go on that video. People, you know, and at the end of the day, that's I think what makes a content creator or an influencer a bad of an image. But I think stick to those two points that I think make a good content creator or an influencer is honesty and intimacy. When we talk about content creators or influencers, the name says it all. Content creators are people who create content. But if you use a product for the sake of making content, for example, you start doing something for the sake of the content, for the sake of the likes, are they called content creators? Content creators are actually people with making content even when they're not, you know, having brands on their side. Let's say photographers, let's say videographers. Without any brands, that's what they do. Now that's a real content creator for me. Whereas influencers are people that are really famous on the internet based on their looks, based on what they do, even based on their job. But they get paid to promote certain things that are not actually in their world. For example, me. I do podcasts here and there. And there's a company from, let's say a t-shirt company. I don't look as good. I'm not a model. But I guess from that side, I'm an influencer. Because I influence people by using that shirt, despite the fact that I use my job. Whereas content creators, they use their job or their backgrounds, their contents, in promoting what they do, in promoting the brands. I think those are the two differences between a content creator and an influencer. Dua hal tersebut, influencer dan juga content creator, bertanggung jawab atas melambangkan sebuah brand. If we look at 1970s and we look at, let's say, Marlboro, people know them as, you know, this guy using a cowboy hat, and that was Marlboro. That was him, that was the real deal. But now, it's a new age customer, whereas trends go like that. And you have to have that intimacy and that honesty vibe with your contents. Karena bukan seperti tahun 70-an yang kalian melihat di televisi kemudian melihat bahwa, I want to be like him. No, because there was only one Marlboro man. Today, there are millions of Marlboro men out there. With what? With your Instagram, with your YouTube, with all that. Now, once you deceive or once you lie about, you know, you liking a certain product, people don't trust you. And as a content creator, that could kill your brand because it's a domino effect with your personal branding. Now, I'm not saying you have to get rid of the money that you receive off of brands that you don't like. You could see the positive side. Let's say if I get endorsed by a watch and it says that, hey, it's really comfortable, and apparently it's not. Look, I'd say to the brand, hey, I have to be honest. I'm not gonna say it's not comfortable. I'm gonna say the other side of it. I really love the details in it. And you could put it out that way because that's the honesty what I meant. And the intimacy is talking with your followers and discuss with them, hey, I really like this. I really think there should be an improvement, because that discussion, that intimacy, that's what matters to your listeners. Karena balik lagi ke tadi, ketika kalian punya panggung, kalian ingin ada pendengarnya, kalian ingin ada orang yang menontonnya. And the way to connect with them is through the intimacy, to talking with them, to just like performers. When you wave your hands, when you look at the crowd, when you talk with them, people love that. Just like having your own stage, your own Instagram page, that's what matters. Talking to your followers and have that engagement. At the end of the day, we all go back to knowing our morals, knowing what is right and what is wrong. And if you feel like what you're doing is wrong, if you feel like you're promoting something that you don't like or sharing something that's not you, I believe that's already a sign of, you know, you not doing what you're supposed to be doing, which is influencing people and making great contents for the people that adore you. But so far, that's what I got. And that's, I hope what I shared today can, you know, make people understand the fact that what's the difference between content creators and influencers and the growth of, I guess, digital demands and how this shift can become this global impact and become a solution for better things in life. But so far, that's from me. My name is Iyas Lawrence, and I hope to see you guys on the next Plaza Indonesia Masterclass.